Right. A service model where the applications develop or use the infrastructure, right? So it is like the hardware system, the network and security, everything has to be done, and which made available through the internet on demand on rent. So you have to pay as per the use or multi-tenancy model, right, by a developer or a user, right? So this is the infrastructure that involves computing system, network and security, right? And data as a service, so it provides the service as a data. And the responsibilities are like a service model where the data store and data warehouse is made available through the internet. So the data has to be stored and properly maintained in a warehouse, and that should be available for the user through the internet on demand on rent basis, right, to an enterprise. And what are the responsibilities? So the data center has to be maintained, right? So the management of the data center. So the 24/7 power control, because the data should be accessible at any time by the user. So that should be a 24/7 power should be available. The control should be available. The network has to be maintained. The system has to be maintained. The database, the hardware system that has to be maintained. And the scale up or scaling down, right? So the data size, as the data size keeps on increasing, the memory should also be increased, right? So there should be a scale up or scale downing should be there. Data replicating is there, and mirror nodes. Say for example, every data cannot be stored in a single place, right? So we need some sort of backup. Or we should have a backup data, right? So the data should be replicated and mirror node should be provided so that you can access your nearest node, right? Instead of going to the faraway node, you can access the same data from the nearby mirror node, right? And there should be some physical security of the data. All these things should be available here, right? So this is actually an example, right? As a service, what all the things provided. On the left hand side, you can see platform as a service. We have seen MS Azure, right? Microsoft Azure is actually a platform as a service, and Google App Engine is a platform that is used as a service. And on the left side, you can see that the Google Docs, Office 365, MS Windows Live, and these are all some software that is available as a service. On the right hand side, infrastructure as a service, again we can have Amazon service. And that EC2, that is the Elastic Computing Cloud, and GoGrid Virtual Servers or Infrastructure as Service. So that is actually the third one. And the fourth one is Data as a Service. We can have Tata Communications, GoGrid Virtual Servers, Amazon Virtual Servers are providing the data centers where we can use our data as a service to others. And we are going to see like two things. One is actually two IoT platforms. The first one is called Zively. So it uses use of cloud IoT, right? Cloud-based service. It's cloud IoT that uses cloud for your service. And the service providers, data collection, and there will be some data points will be there, messages and the calculation objects will also be done. The service also provisions for the generation communication of alerts, triggers, and feeds, right? So whenever there is a it has to be periodically generate alerts and triggers, right, and feeds. Say for example, I have this much of data available, the last data that has come during this part of time, and all those information should be given as alerts and triggers. And a user is an application or a service. The user obtains responses or feeds from the cloud service. So I am actually a user and I am going to use that service, and I will be getting the responses or feeds from the cloud service. And this is actually one example where on the left hand side you can see there is a device or sensor network is available there. That's a communication gateway through which the data is passed to the internet firewall and the database firewall. These two firewalls will provide the data to the cloud service. And in the cloud, we'll be collecting the data and storing it for different application and different services and interfaces, business processes, and intelligence. So we'll be storing this data, and that data will be stored in, say for example, in a bulk data arrangement. And there are plenty of user applications or user services will be available. And this will be accessing the data to make some good decisions, right? Some intelligent decisions and all those things. And to do some business processes, right? And the Zively is actually it is for data capture in real time over the internet, right? And COSM, changed domain name, where using a concept of console, one can monitor the feed, right? So that is again the Zively is the latest domain name. And the cloud service deploys an instance of server at Arduino, right? Again, this is again a part, right? So say for example, on the bottom side, you'll be having different sensors, right? And the sensors can be made as an intelligent sensors by adding some microcontrollers. Say for example, you are going to use an Arduino Uno as a smart sensor to make a sensor smart. So in that case, the cloud service deploys an instance of server at the Arduino, right? So a part of the functions which are useful for transferring the data from the lower end to the upper end will be stored or will be provided in the Arduino at the ground level. And it provides real-time data collection, data visualization, graphical plots, HTTP based APIs and feed. In the sense, the data has to be collected in the real time, and we should be able to visualize the data. I think during the class we have seen how the real-time data is visualized, right, using different graphical plots and different numbers. And there are some HTTP based APIs and feed that are available there. And this is the diagram, right? So on the left hand side you can see there is a device or a sensor network is available, and that thing is coming through the data store or coordinating node, and along with the distributed database node, so which collects the local data and generate some local files which are transmitted to the internet through the internet firewall and database firewall. On the right hand side you can see there is a collect and storage which collects all the data, and there is a infrastructure as a service. You are going to store the data, and again user applications and controlling applications will also be running along with the data, right? So it's a commercial PaaS available for the IoT MTM. And a data aggregator, data mining website is often, because there is going to be plenty of data will be available there. So I need some sort of data aggregator and data mining so that we can get some useful information from the available bulk data, right? So that should also be there. And an IoT PaaS service for business services. So this is actually a IoT platform as a service for services and business services, right? And the Zively PaaS services, so the first thing is data visualization, right? So whatever data available, we can usually visualize through some different types of graphs or some highlighting and all those things, we can do that. And the graphical plots are there, if the collected data can be visualized. It generates alerts, supposing a data exceeds some threshold, then it generates some alerts and some sort of alerts will be there. Access the historical data, that is again important. There is going to be a bulk data, and the data is available from the history. You can access your past data. Say for example, what is the temperature of this particular boiler plant last week, right, or last month, right? How the trend varies, all the things you can see that. And it generates feeds which can be real world objects or of one or others, right? So it will be generating some real world objects. Object is actually a collection of data, we can say, right? So say for example, in a boiler, you can say what is the temperature, what is the pressure, what is the pH value of the water, and what is the fuel that is burnt. A group of collection of data can be termed as object. So this information as a bulk will be available for the owners or others. And the Zively HTTP based APIs. So here easy to implement on device hardware, right, acting as a client to the web services. And APIs connect to the web service and send data. So there are their own library functions or APIs are available which are useful for sending the data from the lower end to the upper end. And the APIs provide service for logging, sharing, displaying and data, sensor data to all, right? The next one is going to be Nimbits. Nimbits also almost similar to your Zively. So it uses a server at the edges, right? A server can be deployed at the edges. There are going to be plenty of device nodes. Already we have seen what is an edge computing. Similarly, we'll be having so many edges or so many device nodes will be available, and which communicates the feed to the cloud servers, right? So the data is passing through different nodes to the cloud servers. The server also provisions for the generation and communication of alerts, triggers and feeds. Of course, similar to your Zively, this also can generate alerts, triggers and feeds to the cloud service. Again, it can be a mirror server, right? So there should be a server and there should be plenty of mirror servers so that the data accessing time can be reduced. And the user applications or services used to collect the data at the cloud infrastructure, right? Of course, we know that. I think that should be a similar thing, right? On the left hand side, you can see there's a sensor network. Again, the data is coordinated and data stored and stored in the distributed database. The data is passed to internet firewall and database firewall. On the right hand side, you can see there is a cloud infrastructure and services, and the data is stored in the database, which will be accessed by different user applications. And the NIMBITS enables the IoT as an open source, right? This is an open source distributed cloud. Anybody can access it. And the NIMBITS Cloud PaaS deploys an instance of NIMBIT, similar to your Xively. Supposing you are going to connect your Arduino sensor to the NIMBITS Cloud server, then some part of cloud server will be available in the Arduino also. That is useful for transmitting data from the sensor to the cloud server. And it functions as a MTM, system data store, data collector and logger, and access to the historical data, similarly what we have seen already. And it's a cloud-based Google App Engine is used as in the basic architecture. And a class hierarchy, com.nimbits.serversystem.serverinfo of the Java language, right? So this is actually the format of accessing the NIMBITS server. The features, so it provides edge computing locally on embedded system built upon local applications, and runs the rules and pushes important data up to the cloud. So there will be some local applications will be there, that is again on the edge computing. And whenever there is some important data, right, and only those data will be sent to the cloud, right, and when connected over the internet, right. So whenever there is an internet, some important data which are useful available in the local nodes will be passed on to the internet. And an instance of NIMBITS server hosts at the device node. Again, as I said, a part of the actual server will also be available at the sensor node, which will be taking care of the local functions. So we need a rule engine, and for connecting sensors, persons and software to the cloud and one another, rules can be calculations, statistics, email alerts. So we have a rule engine, right? So this will be useful for what all the calculations need to be done over the data that's available, what are the statistics to be made, and when an alert has to be generated, to which email address the alert has to be generated, and where to